this might be the end of Sass, or at least the start of preprocessors going away, because CSS is getting extremely powerful. Last video, we talked about functions in vanilla CSS, and now mixins are coming too, and you can already try them in Chrome Canary, and I think this is a huge leap for CSS. The new spec is called CSS Functions and Mixins, and I didn't mention mixins the last time because the spec didn't have the details yet, and it still doesn't have them, but a few days ago, Adam Argyle posted that we can start testing mixins in Chrome Canary. This means that we might soon be getting mixins in Chrome and hopefully other major browsers. Let's take a look at the proposed syntax. And if you used mixins with Sass, it would look very familiar. We start by defining a mixin using the mixin keyword. We give it a name starting with double dash, very similar notation as with CSS custom properties. So let's say I want to create a mixin that's called heading one to create headings of level one. And then we give it some properties. And then we can use this mixin by using the apply keyword with heading one. It would look something like this. We would type in apply heading one and that's it. And then we can also use this mixin on a utility class. So for example, if I had a utility class that's called is style h1 or something similar, we can use the same mixin here and that would work perfectly fine. Now, if you're new to CSS, you might be wondering, why do we even need this? The answer is it helps you separate semantics from visual appearance. So if we had an h3 that looks something like this, we could just give it a class is style h1 that we just created. And this h3 would look like an h1, but semantically it would be heading level 3. So you can think of mixins as chunks of style that you write once and reuse them anywhere you want. And this becomes sort of like your source of truth. One thing I would like to see implemented beyond that is parameters. Here's a cool example by Miriam Suzanne that you can find in the article that I will link in the description. Here's a simple example of a button mixing with conditional logic and style parameters. Imagine you can have a mixing with a parameter that you pass to it, and depending on the value of that parameter, you either render a button with a style outline or a default style. That's pretty cool. I haven't seen any proof that this is actually coming to CSS, so I reached out to Adam on Twitter, and he said that the current implementation in Chrome Canary is actually just the starting point, and we might get parameters as well. So why is this so big, and why am I so hyped about this? See, when preprocessors like Less, Sass, and Stylus appeared, they solved a very specific problem. CSS alone couldn't keep up with the design progress because we started building more systematic design. Design system became a thing, and you had to repeat yourself a lot if you wrote vanilla CSS. Writing Sass felt like magic after vanilla CSS. You got variables, mixins, and functions. And to me, these three features are the core of systematic styles. Sure, Sass does a lot more than that, but the extra stuff feels less important for building systematic styles. Here's how I think about it. We use CSS custom properties for design tokens, and we use mixins to build reusable style chunks like our H1 example. And that's really all you need to build simple systematic styles. And now, or soon, you'll be able to do that in plain CSS. Exciting times. CSS is catching up super fast.